Hello all, welcome back to the VTV Shikshana program for the subject Digital System Design, and we are in the last and the final module, that is module 5, which gives information on the applications of the digital circuits. So this is typically a continuation of the module 4, wherein in the module 4, the second part we had seen the Moore and Mealy machine. So in this particular applications of digital circuits, that is in the module 5, we'll take up different applications and we'll try to build the Mealy or the Moore sequential network or the machines. Okay, so that's what will be the agenda of this. Okay, so just to recap, in previous modules, we analyzed sequential circuits using timing charts and state graphs. Okay, so this is what we have done. Now we will consider the design of sequential circuits starting from a problem statement, which specifies the desired relationship between the input and the output sequence. So in this, the first step in the design is to construct a state table or a graph, which specifies the desired behavior of the circuit. So that will be the first step. So in the first step, we are trying to design or we'll try to construct a state table or graph which specifies the desired behavior of the circuit, how exactly the circuit behaves. So once we are done with this, then the flip-flop input equations and output equations can be derived from the obtained table. Construction of the state table or graph, one of the most important and challenging parts of sequential circuit design, is discussed in detail in this particular module. Okay, so this is what exactly we try to do in this particular module. One of the application of the digital circuit may be a sequence detector. Okay, so before we go into the example of design of a sequence detector, we'll first define what is a sequence detector. A sequence detector is a sequential state machine. Again, I say sequential state machine. When I say a state machine, it can be of Mealy model or Moore model, okay, which takes an input string of bits and generates an output 1 whenever the target sequence has been detected. Okay, so a sequence detector is a sequential state machine which will generate an output 1 whenever the target sequence has been detected at the inputs. Okay, so this is what we really mean. And this is a simple block diagram of a sequence detector, where X is the input, where sequence of or string of bits enter the block in synchronous with the clock, and Z is the output that the sequence detector will generate. And in this particular sequence detector, Z becomes 1, that is the output becomes 1 whenever the target sequence has been detected. Okay, so you can just go ahead this way. The circuit will examine a strings of zeros and ones applied to the input and generate an output Z is equal to 1 only when a prescribed input sequence occurs. It will be assumed that the input X can only change between the clock pulses. Okay, so we are assuming that X is changing in between the clock pulse, okay, not exactly when the clock changes. Okay, so this is the little bit of assumption that we'll be making. Okay, so we'll go to the first example. Okay, is an example for design of a sequence detector. In the sequence, one of the example is this one. So what is this example one says is the problem statement. We will design the circuit so that input sequence ending in 101 will produce an output Z is equal to 1. Meaning what? Whenever we encounter 101 in the string of bits, at that moment, my output Z should become 1, or the circuit should give me 1. Okay, and also it says the circuit does not reset when an 1 output occurs. That means whenever a circuit produces an output 1, whenever the sequence ending in 101 is detected, the circuit doesn't reset. Okay, it will continue from there and then onwards. Okay, we'll try to see this, what is the meaning of this when we try to design actually. Okay, so we can consider a typical input sequence and the corresponding output sequence given below. Okay, so X is the input, as I said, and this is the sequence of inputs that it is coming. first zero, it's a one bit. Next zero, next one, something like that. Okay, you can see that corresponding output. So output Z should become only one, only when there is a 101 pattern present in the sequence of bits. Okay, if I just move ahead with this, okay. So first is zero, next is zero, next is one. You can see that the corresponding Z is 000 because it has not yet detected any pattern. Okay, or the sequence ending in 101. You can see that output is generated with respect to the clock. That means the circuit is in synchronous with the clock. After the first clock, my output is zero because input X is zero. After the second clock pulse, input is zero, output is zero, and output becomes one only when the specific sequence, and in this case, it is 101 is detected. So you can see that 101 detected. My Z becomes one. Next, one is there. So this is the first sequence, first pattern that is detected. Next is one. That's why again the Z is zero. Next is zero. Again it is zero. Next is zero. So it is not detected any 101. So that's why Z is not becoming one. Similar after one, again here. Then we have 101. We can see that after this 101, I have a Z output one. Okay, this is the corresponding. Okay, and that's what after this you can see this statement, right? What this says, that circuit does not reset when one output occurs. That means in this particular sequence, the second time the circuit has detected 101 pattern, that's why it is producing Z is equal to one. Yes. After this, circuit is not resetted. It will continue from where it is left now. Okay. Again, after this one, I have zero and then I have one. So we can see that 101 and 101. So one becomes, this one becomes an integral part of this 101 sequence as well as this 101 sequence. Okay. Suppose if the circuit is getting reset when one output occurs, means this will never become an integrated part. Again, I will go for checking from the next bit onwards. Okay. So that is the meaning. Okay. So that's why 101, this is also considered for the next pattern. Anything 101 occurs, 101, you can see that there are two patterns back to back without resetting the circuit. So this is what, and the number of clock pulses equal. Okay. And this is what we'll try to do now. Okay. And this is the example, and this is what the input sequence and example we have given, and how exactly my output should go ahead. Okay. So once we know the problem statement, then we have to go for finding the state graph. Okay. And that is what we are trying to do. So figure one and figure two use the partial state graph for this particular example. Okay. So we'll try to see how exactly we try to divide now. Okay. So whenever we start any state graph, we should have the initial state. I should be in one of the initial state. Okay. So I consider one of the initial state. Okay. Any one of the state has to be in the initial state. Okay. So make sure that this is one. Okay. So for any of the state, we'll give the state variable name as S with the subscript 0, 1, 2, 3, something. Okay. So whenever I say S naught, okay, this means this is one of the state and this state name is S naught. S naught is one of the state, and this S naught, I consider it as an initial state. Okay. Whenever a sequence detector starts detecting some sequence, its initial state will be in S naught. Okay. That's what I do. Okay. So again, as we have seen the previous case, how exactly the block diagram looks like. I have an input X, okay, and it generates output Z depending upon the application of the clock. The moment clock applied, depending upon X, I will generate the Z now. Okay, so if I am in any state, I have to check what is the corresponding inputs for me. Okay, and in this case, it is only one variable, that is one bit. So if I am in initial state S naught, I get the X value. Yes. X value may be either 0 or X value may be either 1. Okay, that's what. And whenever I'm designing a state graph for this particular example, make sure that when x is equal to 0, what will happen? And when x is equal to 1, what will happen? Okay, so that is very important for us. Okay, so now in this example, we know that if the pattern is 1, 0, 1, okay, if I get any sequence with a sequence ending 1, 0, 1, at the end of this particular sequence, my output z should be 1. Okay, this is what I have. This is x. Okay. And this has to be 0, this has to be 0. I know that, right? This is what? Yes. Suppose if x is equal to 0, this is the sequence that I'm interested in, right? Pattern. That means whenever I get the very first value of x as 1, then I'm interested next maybe 0 or something like that. Okay. If the very first bit is 0 means I reset, never let my z to be 1. Okay. It will be 0. I will never go to any other state. Meaning the moment I get x value something like 0, I remain in the same state because I'm not interested in that value of x, which is 0. Yes. Because I know the pattern. What is my pattern I want? I want 1, 0, 1. If I get x is equal to 0, I'm least worried. So what I make? I let output 0 and I return in the same state. Instead of 0, if I get one something like this, then I am interested in going to another, the next state. Okay, this I call it as something like S1. What is my, if it is 1, I move to next state, that is S1, with still output being 0, because output goes to 1 only after detecting 1, 0, 1 in sequence. In sequence, it should be 1 after the other. Okay, this is what. And this is what is depicted here. If it is 0 input, be in the same state, output letting 0. If it is 1, go to the next state, that is S1, still being output 0. This is what. Is it clear? So if I say that the circuit is in state S0 means it is expecting 1. If it is 0, it will be in the same state. If it is 1, it will go to S1. So if the circuit is in S1 means I think that, okay, I have reached S1 only when the x input was 1. Okay, so that's what. Again, when I'm in S1, okay, now I've moved from S0 to S1. Again, I'll be checking what? I'll be checking with respect to what is my x. Again, two possibilities of x. It may be 0 or 1, right? If it is 0, I know that. Okay, 1, 0. So I'm sensing some pattern there. If I'm sensing some pattern, move to the next state, which I call this as something like S2. Okay. I call this as something like S2. Okay. When this will happen? 0. Still my output is not 1 because I've just encountered 1, 0. Okay. If I'm in S1, I have encountered 1. If I move from S1 to S2 means I've encountered something 0. So if I move from S0 to S1, it is 1. If I move from S1 to S2, it is 0. That means I've covered 1, 0. If I'm in S0 and if I retain S in S0 only, then it means 0. Is that okay? So at S0, if you encounter 0, I'll move to S2. Suppose if I encounter 1, what I have to do? Be in the same state. Okay, don't go anywhere. Be in the same state. Is that okay? By letting output to be 0. And this is 1. So if I get x is equal to 1, be in the same state, don't move anywhere. Yes. Now I am in the last state S2, right? S2. And again, if the moment I come to S2 means I have encountered 1 and 0. That is the meaning. At S2, again, I have to check what is my x value. Again, it is 0 or 1. If it is 0, what? Go back to the initial state because I have not encountered the 1, 0, 1. That's it. If I get 1, what means? If I am at S2, I have already traced 1, 0. If I get 1 at S2, that means I have encountered what? 1, 0, 1. Let the output to be 1. This is what. And this is what is really happening here. And that is what is shown in the next particular slide. This is the complete picture of the state graph for the sequence detector for an example one, wherein we are trying to detect the input sequence 101. Okay, at the end of 101, I have the output should be 1, and the circuit will not reset. Okay, when the output becomes 1, and this is what we'll try to analyze again here. Okay, this is my initial state. S naught is my initial state. Okay, I'll specify something like this one. Okay, again, if I get 0, that is not the pattern I am interested in, so I retain the same state. If I get 1, I'm encountering the first one there, go to the next state. In S1, if I get 0, that is what I'm expecting. 1, 0 means go to the next state. If not, be in the same state if it is 1. At S2, if I get 0, I'm not interested in 1, 0, 0. That's why I go to the initial state with 0. If I get 1, that means 1 year, 0 year, 1 year means I get that. So if I'm moving from S2 to S1 by letting output 1, means I've got the pattern 101, I've made output to be 1, and I'm not resetting the circuit. So that's why I'm going back to S1 only. If I want to reset, I go to S0, that's it. Okay, so this is what the truth table is all about. Yeah, now I can take this example and see how many times my Z becomes 1 year, right? So what is the very first value of X? 0. I'm in initial state S0, I retain in the same state. Next, what is the second value of X? Again, it is 0. That means after the second clock pulse, I mean by. So again, I'll be staying. If I'm in S0 and if I keep on getting 0, I retain in the same state. I do nothing. Next is what? 1. The moment I get 1, I move to the next state S1 by letting output 0 only. Yes. At S1, I'll be checking for 0 or 1. Yes. What is this? 1. If it is 1, retain in the same state. Why? If it is 0, then I can sense 1, 0. 1, 0, 1 is a sequence that I'm interested. If I get 1, 1, that is not the sequence, be there. Okay. Then if, what is the next? 0. Okay. I'm encountered previously 1. Now it is 0. Go to the next state. So at S1, retain in the same state if it is 1 input. If not, go to S if the input is 0. Again, by letting output to 0. So we can count here. Now we are in the this value at S2. At S2 now, we have encountered 1, meaning I'm sure that when I'm in S2, if I get X is equal to 1, I'm sure we have detected 1, 0, 1. That's why I'm letting the output to be 1 and moving to the S1 state, not resetting. If I want to reset, I'll just go here. Yes. And this keeps on going. This is what exactly the state graph, that to Mealy. Why Mealy? Because the output is outside the state and it is depending upon the input as well as on the present state. That's why it is called Mealy. Next, since I have 3 state variables, in order to represent 3, I want to have minimum 2 bits, right? So one is S0, another is S1, and another is S2. I decode this in terms of bit. S0, I decode it as 0, 0, because I have 3 state, okay? For 0, S0, I'm encoding it as 0, 0. For S1, I'm encoding it as 0, 1. And for S2, I'm encoding it as 1, 0. Okay, you can encode with 2 bits in any pattern. Need not that S0 has to be 0, 0. It can be S0, 1 only. But I'm going in this particular fashion. Okay. So here, what I will try to do is now, from the state graph, okay, we try to build the state table. Okay. So we try to build the state graph. And that's what they mentioned, right? Once the problem statement is there, obtain the state graph or state table. So we try to obtain both the state graph as well as the state table. Okay. So in this state table, again, similar to the sequential synchronous counter design, we have a present state and the next state. Okay. And we are defining the next state here. Okay. Not only with respect to the present state, but also with respect to the input. X is my input. Okay. So next state depends upon the present state and the next state. Even the output also depends upon the present state and the x input. Okay. Since we have three states, I am letting S0, S1, S2. Then depending upon x value, I move from S0 to S1 or I return in the S0. For example, here, the next state of S0 when x is equal to 0 is S0 only. So I'm in S0. If the x is 0, I return in the same state. That's what. If x is equal to 1 means I move to the next state. Similarly, if I'm in S1, if x is 1, return in the same state. If x is equal to 0, go to the next state, that is S2. If I'm in S2, if x is equal to 0, the next state is S0. If x is equal to 1, next state is S1. Okay. And the present output, that is Z, what I mean by here. Okay. And Z becomes 1 only when I am in state S2. You can see in the graph, right? And S2, if the present state is S2, and if the input x is equal to 1, only then my Z is equal to 1. In rest all cases, my Z is equal to 0. What is the meaning of this? If I am in S0, if I move from S0 to S1, and when I move from S0 to S1, when x is equal to 1, and if I am in S1, and I go to S2, only when x is equal to 0, and when I'm in S2, I will go to S1 only when x is equal to 1. That means I've encountered 101, then only my Z becomes 1, something like that. This is one. And now what we do? We try to encode S0 with 00, S1 with 01, and S2 with 10. So wherever S0 is there, you replace by 00. And why two bits we have used? I've already told. And wherever S1 is there, you replace it by 01. And wherever S2 is there, you replace it by 10. Is that okay? So this is the A plus. So what you can do now is, it is something like this. Based on your X value, A value, and B value, you will find out what is your next state of A flip-flop and what is your next state of B flip-flop. That's what. Here, this is what. So total, there are three variables now. Okay. Two are with respect to your present state. And one is with respect to the input. Okay. Yes, I have present state and the input. So total three variables I should look in, from 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. Okay. Present state, AB 0, 0. Yes. Two bits means two flip-flop, you know, and one flip-flop I call it as A and another flip-flop I call it as B. And here I try to design the circuit using D flip-flop. Okay, that's what will be. I can design using any flip-flop now. I can take using, or I can design using JK flip-flop also. If they specifically say that design using JK, you use the next state with respect to the JK, something like that. Okay. Now, x is equal to 0. For different combination. I'm just rearranging this table in terms of this. That's it. Okay. There is no change between this and that. Okay. This is 0, 1, 1. This is 1, 0, 0. This is 1, 0, 1. This is 1, 1, 0. I will take, and next I will grab it as 1. Okay. So present state 0. Next state will be 0. When the present state S0, next state S0 means when x is equal to 0, that's what this will become, 0, 0. Is that okay? AB, present state, what is this? If I'm in present state 0, 1, if x is equal to 0, go to the next state, that is 1, 0. That's it. If the present state is 1, 0, okay. If the present state is 1, 0, what is 1, 0? This one. When x is equal to 0, I'll go to 0, 0. And I don't have any present state 1, 1. This will be something like don't care, okay? Something. Again, you can just fill. So whatever you have done here, I'm just rearranging in terms of x as one column, A one column, B one column, and that is the next step. This is my next state column. This is the present state and this is the input. Now, I have to find the expression for A and B with respect to D flip-flop. Yes. And what is the next state of D flip flop is all about? It is the D input itself. Yes. So what? Use the three variable K-map. Why three variable? Present state plus input gives me three variable X, E, B. Okay. For different values of 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 1, fill this. Okay. So that's what we'll try to see in the next slide. Yeah. Okay. You can see that. So whenever the present state is 1, 1, I have considered this has to be don't care. So the next state I'll get as something like X bar B. This is nothing but what? The input for me. Okay. What is this basically? This is basically A plus is nothing but what? X bar B, which is nothing but what? The input for A flip-flop. B plus is nothing but what? X, which is nothing but what? The input for this. Because we know that for the D flip-flop, next state is equal to D, or in other words, D is nothing but what? My next state. Okay, so that's why whatever the next state expression I get, I directly give it for DA. For A plus, it is input for DA. B plus means it is the next state of B flip flop, which is nothing but what the input for BB. And again, similarly, we construct the, or we get the expression for ZX, which is nothing but what XA. So this is A flip flop. This is my B flip flop. These are the inputs. This is with respect to A input. This is with respect to B input. Clock is common clock. Then DA is given by X bar B. DB is simply X. Z is equal to X into A. Okay. This is the circuit that we obtained from this. So from the given problem statement, we understood what is the problem. Then we could get the state graph. From state graph, we could get the state table. From the state table, depending upon using which flip-flop you design the circuit, you obtain the expressions. From the expressions, you can build the circuit. Okay. And this is a Mealy circuit for the 101 sequence detector. Okay. So this is all about example one. And the same problem statement, we'll try to design the Moore machine in the next session. Thank you.